Good afternoon. How you doing? CitizenAY here. Just a quick one, really. I'm sure you've all got the news today. I've been following it closely. Around about just after 1 o'clock this afternoon, apparently, we've heard that Sowore has been granted bail. Quick summary of what they've done. He's been granted 100 million with sureties and the like sum, 100 million naira. And he must have landed property in Abuja and deposit 50 million. Shall not hold or speak in public, in any public rallies, must not travel outside Abuja. Sureties must have tax clearance up to date to be remanded in prison pending perfection of bail. Second defendant, 50 million with sureties, shall not travel outside of Osun State. Must not hold or speak to anybody, speak in any public forum. I shall be remanded in prison pending further perfection of bail. This is later. Listen, that's just a brief update. I've been following what was going on. Look, it's cautious times we're in now. We all remember what happened last week. Last week, we were given the runaround. This week, let's not fall for that trick. Let's not fall for that game. The government, what they are doing here is wrong in any case. He was already granted bail earlier on. So this is a nonsense. Nothing for us to jump up and down about. What is important for all of us is to make sure that Sowore is indeed granted bail. No doubt they will meet the bail conditions. I'm sure they are doing things around and in the behind the scenes to meet the bail conditions. But what I want us all to be very, very conscious of right now is, please do not celebrate anything. Don't go jumping up and down and thinking this is a long game. This is a long game. We are going. This is a long stretch. This is going to go on for some time. So I'm saying to you all, please don't fall for the trick. To ask for somebody who's actually standing up for the people. Just look at the roads in Nigeria, who's speaking up for the people, and you're asking him to go and bring 100 million naira surety bail, landed property, and then asking Olawale Bakare, the young 21-year-old, again, 50 million naira. I mean, they're trying to make it as difficult as possible for them to meet the bail conditions. That's what they're trying to do. So, as we all know, last week, like I said, the government should have released Sowore and the young man, but they didn't. They have trampled upon our democracy. So there's nothing to celebrate here until we see Sowore come out. So I'm saying it now. You have it in my head. Revolution now. Revolution now. Revolution now. And we are not going to stop. I want to thank all of those who came yesterday and who protested outside the Nigerian High Commission in London yesterday. Great work. We're watching what's going on, but this time around, let's be savvy about what we do. Now, there's no celebration until we see Sowore out of that place. He must be out. So, like I said, I did say that last time, but this time I really do mean it. Please, let's not celebrate anything. Let's wait. Let's wait. Let's make sure that the government complies. Because now, for the first time, the government failed to comply with what the court said. Now, we now wait to see if they're going to comply with it the second time around. So, I'll be back in a few minutes. I wanted to just state this first before I came back and spoke live. But, I'll be in touch. Later. Bye.